Hello friends, in this lecture we will continue with our discussion on admission of a partner in this we were discussing about the topic of goodwill right what is goodwill goodwill is reputation right why it is important to study goodwill in admission of a partner because the new partner who is joining the firm is going to enjoy the reputation is going to enjoy the goodwill that has been earned by the old partners right for this he must compensate the old partners by paying premium for goodwill right this all we have discussed in detail in the previous lectures I'll move further we discussed about the various ways in which this premium for goodwill is paid one is privately in case the premium for goodwill is paid privately no record to be done in the books second is the premium for goodwill is paid in cash and retained in business then we will receive the premium for goodwill in cash and then that premium for goodwill will be adjusted through the partners capital accounts why because as per AS 26 the goodwill is not to appear in the books it is to be adjusted through the partners capital accounts Now we have third case. Case 3. What is case 3? That premium for goodwill is brought in kind. The premium for goodwill is brought in kind by the new partner. What do you mean by brought in kind? Brought in kind means in the form of assets. Instead of cash, the new partner brings in some assets for his premium of goodwill on the joining of partnership firm. Clear? So, how to record this? Earlier, if you remember in the previous lectures when the goodwill was received in cash and retained in business we used to pass a journal entry that is cash account debit to premium for goodwill account now here he is not bringing cash he is bringing some asset so we will not write cash here instead of cash we will write asset account debit to premium for goodwill account right then this premium of goodwill it is to be distributed among the old partners in which ratio I told you in the sacrificing ratio always we will adjust this premium for goodwill through the old partners capital accounts why because as per accounting standard 26 this goodwill is not to be shown in the books to old partners capital accounts right in which ratio in sacrificing ratio what is a sacrificing ratio it is old share minus the new share right this is sacrificing ratio clear so nothing major in this thing the premium of goodwill is brought in kind instead of cash we have to write only the name of the asset that has been brought in if the cash, he is bringing the premium for goodwill in cash, we will write down cash. But now he is not bringing it in cash, then we will write at asset. Asset to premium for goodwill, and then this premium for goodwill will be adjusted through the old partner's capital accounts in the sacrificing ratio. Clear? Let's see one practical problem on this case. X and Y are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. On 1st of April 2016, they admit Z as a new partner for 3/13th share in the profits. The new ratio will be 5:5:3. Z contributed the following assets to his capital and his share for goodwill. Instead of bringing cash for capital and goodwill, he brought some assets. He brought stock ₹80,000, debtors ₹1,20,000, land ₹2,00,000, plant and machinery ₹1,20,000. On the date of admission of Z, the goodwill of the firm was valued at ₹10,40,000. Record the necessary journal entries. Be careful, we are given the goodwill of the whole firm. Right. Let's write down the facts first. There are two partners, X and Y. They are sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. Z is admitted as the new partner for 3/13th share in profits. What is the new profit sharing ratio? 5:5:3. Right? Now, I told you in the previous lectures also that always first calculate the sacrificing ratio. We always need a sacrificing ratio in this case. Why? Because we have to adjust the premium for goodwill through the old partner's capital accounts in sacrificing ratio. Right? So, what is sacrificing ratio? This comes to old share minus new share. If I talk of X, what is the old share? 3/5. What is the new share? 5/13. So this comes to 14/65. Now, Y, old share 2/5, new share 5/13. This comes to 1/65. So what is the sacrificing ratio? Sacrificing ratio comes to 14:1. Right? Now, second thing, calculate the amount of compensation, amount of premium for goodwill to be brought in by the new partner. Okay? We'll say amount of premium to be brought by Z. This is total goodwill multiplied by share of Z. What is the total goodwill of the firm? See the question. The total goodwill of the firm is given as 10,40,000. So the total goodwill is 10,40,000 and the share of Z is 3/13. So this comes to ₹2,40,000. Right? These are the two common steps that we have to do. First of all, calculate the sacrificing ratio. Then calculate the amount of premium for goodwill to be brought in by the new partner, that is Z. Right? Now, let's move to the journal entries. Let's see the first entry. Earlier it used to be cash to capital to premium for goodwill. When when the premium for goodwill is brought in cash. Here the premium for goodwill is brought in kind. They have told us they have brought in the various assets. What are the assets? Stock 80,000. Let's write down. If the asset is coming into the business, it will be debited. As per the rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Stock debit 80,000. Next asset, see the question. Debtors 1,20,000. Debtors account debit 1,20,000. Next we have land 2,00,000 and plant and machinery 1,20,000. We'll say land account debit 2,00,000 and plant and machinery account debit 1,20,000. Now what is the total? Total is 5,20,000. 5,20,000. Right? Now we have calculated here that the amount of premium brought in is 2,40,000. Out of this 5,00,000, 2,40,000 is for goodwill premium. What is the remaining amount? 2,80,000. Now what is this 2,80,000? Read the question carefully. It says Z contributed the following assets to his capital and his share for goodwill. We know the share for goodwill is 2,40,000. Then what is this 2,80,000? 2,80,000 is his capital. So what we are going to do is we will write as to Z's capital account as 2,80,000 and to premium for goodwill as 2,40,000. This also comes to 520. Clear? So what we were given in the question, we were given that he has brought in some assets for his capital plus premium. First of all, we identified what is the amount of premium for goodwill, and rest is the Z's capital. Now the same logic, this premium of goodwill will be adjusted through the old partner's capital accounts. So we'll write as premium for goodwill account debit. What is the amount? 2,40,000 to who are the old partners? X capital account and to Y's capital account. What is the sacrificing ratio? See, sacrificing ratio is 14:1. So we will divide this premium for goodwill in the sacrificing ratio of 14:1. This will come to 2,24,000 and 16,000. Right? So this is the case where the goodwill is brought in kind by the new partner, and in this case we will debit the assets and credit the capital and the premium for goodwill account. Then similarly, the premium for goodwill account will be adjusted through the old partner's capital account in which ratio? In sacrificing ratio. What is the sacrificing ratio? Sacrificing ratio is old share minus the new share. Right? So this was case 3 in the process of goodwill brought in by the new partner. In the next lecture, we'll discuss about case 4 where the goodwill brought in by a new partner is withdrawn by old partners. Right? What it means that the new partner, he brought the premium for goodwill in cash. That cash is adjusted through the partner's capital accounts. We credit the old partner's capital accounts. But what the old partners do is they withdraw that premium for goodwill from the business. They withdraw that cash from the business. This is a very simple case. Again, like this third case, it is going to be a very simple case. Right? So that's all for this lecture. Thank you, friends.